Hello and welcome to the QuickResim CFD Toolbox for MATLAB, tutorial number 12. In this tutorial we will perform a simulation of a benchmark problem of development of boundary layer over the flat plate. First of all, we have to read the very simple rectangular mesh of the flat plate and generate the boundary layer on it. Please refer to tutorial number 5 or 9. For more details about the boundary layer generation. For now, let's just have a look on what has been generated. The no-slip wall is on the bottom, velocity inlet is on the left, outflow is on the right, and slip velocity condition is on the top. Let's have a look at how fine boundary layer actually is. Yep, so we can see how it's being developed. Okay, so furthermore, we define fluid properties, again, that's flow of air. We initialize our solution with zero velocity, set convergence criterion at 10 to minus 6. We want to do no more than 100 time steps, and we will use 0.8 alpha relaxation parameter. We'll also need the wall distance for this turbulence model. Again, please refer to tutorial number 9 for more details about that. The inlet velocity profile is simply constant horizontal velocity equal to 10. And our iterative loop. The turbulence model requires turbulent viscosity being calculated. Here we will be using the so-called Van Driest model. This is still an algebraic turbulence model. It has been implemented according to this reference. Some details can be already found in the PDF devoted for our tutorial, where you can see that the turbulence viscosity is based on the gradient of horizontal velocity times square of the mixing length, and this mixing length is defined using the Y plus parameter. Y plus itself is a very common turbulent quantity in CFD, that's called the normalized distance to the wall, because many turbulent flows are similar, but they occur at many scales, so we have to rescale the real coordinate y with using the so-called friction velocity and simple flow viscosity. And friction velocity is divided as a square root of gradient of velocity at the wall times viscosity. Okay, let's continue. Again, under relaxation is used, so velocity is a combination of previous velocity step and one further step backwards. We assemble the Navier-Stokes matrix. We will be using stabilization SUPGW asymptotic because otherwise solution wouldn't converge. Boundary conditions are simple because inlet is on the left, wall is on the bottom, slip is on the top, and there is no need for the outlet boundary conditions. That means there's average zero pressure. Further things on standard. So we compute the residuals, plot them, stop calculations if they are converged, solve the system of equations, and additionally save the quantity for the under relaxation process. Okay, so let's run the simulation. For now, without post-processing. We will have to give it some time for convergence. The convergence process is pretty slow, therefore we just spare you this part of the movie. You can see that it's already like 20 time step. Okay, the solution converged after 45 time steps. Let's move to the post-processing. First, let's have a look at the distribution of vex velocity in the flow. Yeah, everything is red. But when you have a deeper look into the boundary layer, you can see that it starts developing on the leading edge of the plate and it's really, really thin. Yeah, so it looks like that. What we do in the next step is we compare the velocity profile at the outlet to the thing that is given by the analytical equation. The analytical equation has the following form. That's the velocity in the boundary layer as a function of the boundary layer thickness and outflow velocity, I mean the free stream velocity, and that's the boundary layer thickness. Okay, so let's have a look how it works. So we need to extract the node IDs on the right edge. We use extract node IDs on edges. We calculate the thickness of the boundary layer at the outlet and velocity at the outlet. And we plot all the relevant variables. And here we go. The reference solution that results from the formula has the form of pluses here. Boundary layer converges to velocity equal to 10, and our simulation results form has the form of red circles. And it's a fairly good comparison, taking into account that the turbulence model is not the most advanced one, and that the mesh is not of superb quality, rather decent for tutorial case. We can say that the results are pretty good. Okay, so let's additionally visualize Y plus on our grid. We'll create another figure and display the solution and set the extra limit for Y plus from 0 to 5 because Y plus will be really, really large in the free stream case because the nodes are outside, far outside the wall. But we just have to make sure that Y plus is less or equal to 1 in our boundary layer most collapsed node, the node that's exactly to the wall. Yeah, so here you can hardly see anything, but let's just have a look at how it looks in the vicinity of the wall. Yeah, and it looks good because you can see that the values of Y plus are below 1. From this we can infer that the boundary layer has been properly result. Okay, so that's pretty much it regarding tutorial number 12. We hope you enjoyed that. Please visit our website quickersim.com/cfdtoolbox and drop us a comment or a like if you consider those resources relevant. Thanks for your attention.